Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you three ways to make a heart, going from kind of easiest to hardest, although the hardest isn't very hard. And then I'm going to go over a bunch of ways that you can use a heart in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. All right, now we're here in Adobe Illustrator, and I'm just going to create a new document. So I'll come over here to Create New. I'll choose Print up here at the top, and then I'll come down here to Create. Okay, so now we have just an 8.5 by 11 document. Now for this tutorial, you'll want to turn on your smart guides. So I'm going to hit Command K or Control K on a PC, and I'll come down here to smart guides. I'm going to make sure that all of these are checked, and then we'll come down here and say okay. All right, now the first way I'm going to show you is the easiest. So first we'll get our M tool, which is the rectangle tool. All you have to do to get to it is to hit M on your keyboard. And so I'm just going to click and drag a kind of long rectangle like this. And then I'm going to copy that with Command C or Control C and paste in front with Command F or Control F. Then I'll get on a corner like this. Now, if you don't see a bounding box, which is these little points and lines out here, you can hit Shift Command B or Shift Control B to toggle that off and on. So anyway, I'll get on my selection tool. I'll get right on a corner here until I get this rotate tool. So you don't want to be right on the corner. You just want to be right outside it and you'll get the rotate icon. I'm going to start clicking and dragging and then I'll hold Shift until it snaps at a 90 degree angle. So now we have two rectangles on top of each other. I'm going to select both and I'll hit D on my keyboard to get a white fill and a black outline. Now I'm going to hit A to get on my direct selection tool. I'll call that my A tool. Then you'll see you have little white circles with a blue dot inside them. You'll want to get right on that and click and drag in like this. So now all of these corners are rounded out here. Now, if you don't have those, that probably means you're on Illustrator CS6 or earlier. You can still do this by going up to Effect, Stylize, and Round Corners right here, and then changing the radius until it becomes like a circle. So we'll say okay. You're probably starting to see a little heart shape in here, so we need to rotate this again. I'll hit V to get back on my selection tool. And as I said, if you don't have your bounding box on, turn that on with Shift Command B or Shift Control B. And then I'm going to hold Shift and rotate this back around. Now we want to get on our Shape Builder tool, which is Shift M. It's right over here, the Shape Builder tool. And then I'm going to hold Option or Alt and just click on these areas out here to remove them. I'll let off of Option and Alt so that I can combine the shapes with the Shape Builder tool. So with nothing held down, I'll just drag across these three. And now we have our heart. I'm going to change my color. By the way, if you don't have some of these panels open, you can come up here to Window and they're all available right here. So color is right here. Oh, I just made it go away. Okay. And I'm going to change my heart to kind of a red heart. I'll bring my stroke to the front and just get rid of that. Okay, so that is heart number one. That is the easiest way that I know to make a heart. Now, the second way to make a heart is by using the Convert Anchor Point tool. So I'll hit M on my keyboard to get my rectangle tool, and this time I'm going to draw a square. So I'm holding Shift to draw a square. I'll get back on my V tool, which is my selection tool right up here. I'll get on the edge to rotate. I'll hold Shift so that the point will be at the bottom right here. Now I'll hit P to get on my pen tool, and I'll hold Option or Alt to switch over to my Convert Anchor Point tool. And I'll just click here and I'm going to drag this up and I'll hold Shift until I have kind of the heart shape that I'm looking for. Okay, now you can see we have half of the heart done. Now I'm going to hit O on my keyboard to get to my Reflect tool, which is right over here. And I'm going to hold Option or Alt and I'll click right on this bottom point. And that'll reflect it. We'll want to make sure that vertical is chosen, and then we'll go ahead and make a copy. And it'll anchor it right from that point that we chose right down here. Okay, so we have both of our pieces of the heart. I'm going to select both with my selection tool. And then I'll come down here to Pathfinder and just unite these with the first shape mode. Okay, so that's the second way to draw a heart. Now, you might notice that both of these have straight lines right down here. And if you want to have this kind of curve out and then come back to a point, there's another way to make a heart. And this one is a little more advanced, but I'll walk you through it step by step. Okay, so for this, we're going to draw a circle. So I'll hit L on my keyboard. I'm going to click and drag holding shift and just make a big circle. I'll hit P on my keyboard. I'm going to get right on this anchor point, but I'll hold shift so I don't remove that anchor point. I want to draw from this anchor point. So I'm going to click once and I'm just going to come somewhere down here. This looks fine. And I'm holding shift so I get right along that same plane and I'm going to click again. Now I'm going to get right above this halfway point, right about here, and click and drag. And I want to match that part of the circle as close as possible. There we go. I'm going to click back on that last anchor point to get rid of that handle, and then I'll complete the shape right here. Okay, I'm going to zoom in by hitting Z on my keyboard, and we'll just look at this closely. I'll hit Command Y to see what we've got, and I did a pretty good job of matching this part of the shape. But if yours is off a little bit, you can hit A and grab that and just change your handle so it matches that a little better. I'll undo. And I'll hit Command Y to get back. Now at this point, I'm going to make a copy. So I'll hold Option or Alt, and I'm just going to drag this over to the side so we can have it in case we decide we don't like what we're going to make, which is a little bit destructive going forward. So I'm going to select both of these with my selection tool. I'm going to get on my R tool. Your R tool is the rotate tool, and it's right over here. You can hit R on your keyboard to get there. And then I'm going to click once on this point up here. And then I'm just going to rotate this around a little bit like this. Okay, this is looking good. And now I'll hit O on my keyboard. And I'm going to Option and click the same anchor point so that we can reflect. O will get us to that reflect tool if you remember from before. Okay, and let's make a copy. So now we have all of our shapes the way we want them. Now I'm going to select the ones on this side with my selection tool and just arrow those over holding shift because I don't like how this looks up here. So you can really adjust this a little better to your liking. Okay, now I'm going to select both pieces and I'm going to hit shift M to get my shape builder tool, which is right here. And I'm going to remove these two down here by holding Option or Alt and just clicking those pieces. And then I'm going to hold Shift while I'm on the Shape Builder tool and just draw a box around the whole thing. And that will completely combine everything. This is going to give us a more rounded heart right around here at the bottom. So that is the third way to draw a heart. And I think my favorite two hearts are this one and this one. This one just looks a little bit weird in my opinion. But I do see hearts like that a lot. So now I'm going to show you a few cool things that you can do with hearts once you have them drawn. And you can do these with any shape, actually. So I'm going to hold Option and drag this heart down below. Option or Alt will make a copy of it. I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. And I'm going to give this heart a white outline. So I'll come up here to Color. I'll go to Stroke, and I'll increase the stroke just a little bit. To maybe 3 or something like that. Then I'm going to hold Shift and Option and make a copy of this and make it a little bigger. I'm holding Shift and Option again to resize from the middle and make it proportional. I'll hit X to bring my fill to the front and I'm just going to change this to kind of a purpley color. That looks good. And now I'm going to blend these together. So to do that, I'll get on my blend tool right over here and I'll double click it. I want to choose specified steps and I want, well, I think we'll do 8. 8 looks good. So we'll say okay. Now on that same tool, you can click on one and then click on the other and it will blend them together from red to purple. And you can also actually change things once it's already blended. So I'm going to get on my group selection tool and just click this one and make it a little bit smaller so you can see what happens. And we can also move it out this way and you can see how that blend works from large to small. So that's one cool thing that you can do with a heart. Okay, this time I'm going to use this heart. I'm going to make a copy with Option or Alt and I'm going to make this one quite a bit smaller. I'm going to click on my symbols over here. If you can't find it, it'll also be in Window. And I'm just going to click and drag this into my symbols panel. and I'll get this dialog box, and here I can make some changes. I don't need to name it, but I'm going to change the type to a graphic, and we'll say okay. And now I can get on my symbol sprayer, which is right here, symbol sprayer tool. It's underneath your eyedropper tool. And then you can click and drag and just have a whole bunch of those symbols randomly appearing. Now I can get back on my symbol sprayer tool and get underneath it to the symbol sizer tool. I'm just gonna click and some of these will get bigger. So I have some big ones and some small ones. Now I'll get back on that tool and get underneath it and we'll get the symbol spinner tool. And when you use this tool, you get a lot of little arrows that you can manipulate. So now we have a lot of hearts all sprayed on there. So if you really wanted to do this quickly, you can do that with the symbol sprayer, sizer, and spinner. Now let's say we didn't want them to overlap as much, and maybe we want to give them a white outline. To do that, we can just take our symbol, pull it out, make it a little bit smaller. I'll zoom in on it. I'm going to expand it with Command E or Control E. You can also go to up to Object, Expand, and do it that way. And then we can add a stroke around it. So we'll add a 2-point stroke. I'm going to make it a little bit smaller still. We'll zoom back out with Command minus or Control minus. And then I'm just going to hold Option and drag it right on top of that old symbol. And now it updates everywhere. So you can see all those places where it overlaps. There's now a white outline around it. Okay, so now let's take this heart. I'm going to Option and drag it down here. And I'm going to make it quite a bit smaller too. And I'm going to show you how to make a brush out of this heart. It's very similar to the symbols. You just open your brushes panel and you just click and drag it right into your brushes. And then you have to say what kind of brush you want. Let's do pattern brush first. So we'll say okay, and it'll give us some options. We definitely want more spacing between here in my opinion. So as you increase the spacing, you can see a preview right down here. Okay, that looks good. So we'll say okay. Now I'm going to hit L to get on my ellipse tool. I'll hold shift and draw a circle. And now I'm going to apply this brush to it. And I don't want to fill on this, so I'll click on that and get rid of it. And now you can see the brush has been applied to the circle. It's pretty cool. You can also hit B on your keyboard, get on your brush and just draw a line like this, and that brush will be applied to the line. Now you'll notice that it does distort as it's going around a corner. If you don't want distortion, the way to fix it is to just drag that heart back into your brushes panel and create a different type of brush, a scatter brush. So we'll say okay. And this one will keep all the hearts straight up and down. So if I draw a similar shape, it'll look like this. Now we can also increase the spacing by double clicking that brush and just changing the spacing a little bit like this. Let's preview. We'll reduce quite a bit. Oh, that's too much. Okay. So maybe something like this is a little more natural. And we'll say okay. Now we could even apply one of these brushes to one of the hearts we have. So I'm going to increase the size of this heart, pull my brushes out, and then I think we'll just use this one. And although this does need some tweaking, on the corners it does some weird things like this, but it gives you an interesting look for sure. Let's try this other brush. This might be the way to go. We'd have to fix this down here at the bottom, but this is looking pretty nice. So that's three ways to make a heart and a bunch of extra stuff that you can do with hearts once it's made. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.